is not sponsored. I'm just doing this out of pure enjoyment. But yeah, so let's just go ahead and hop right in. I have the app pulled up on my phone, so I'm gonna be putting it on the screen so you guys can see what's happening. Do you guys like my new blue mic cover? My cat actually chewed up my original one, like literally ate chunks out of it, so I had to buy a new one. So I got a two-pack, one with a blue one and then one with a black one, but I thought I'd try out the blue one today. Okay, so here we are in BITLIFE, and let's just create a new life. Of course, we get an ad, but that's okay, BITLIFE. Go ahead, get your coin. I have no issues with that. The tea is people need ads to make money and live, so we support. My name is Alexa Skeleton Bader. Sounds like skeleton. Does that mean we're skinny? Like a skeleton. I was a result of an affair. My birthday is January 2nd. I'm a Capricorn. Dang, my mom is 28. My dad's 43, so my mom was a sugar baby. We are ugly. Like, boy, our mug. Ooh. It ain't looking hot for us. We are not gonna get any boys in school. So, that's fun. Our smarts are kind of low, too. So, we don't really have too much going for us. But hopefully, we can figure something out. Plastic surgery or something, you know? Well, we gotta do something to get a man, okay? Or a woman. We could be gay, who knows? You know, bisexual, anything like that. There's not really much you can do as a baby, so I'm just gonna age us up a little bit. Our looks went up by 1%, so we got a little bit cuter, thankfully. I think that's normal, though. Honestly, realty, I feel like most newborns fresh out the vagina, like the hoo-ha, whatever, aren't that cute, but maybe that's just me. Okay, 2 years, 3 years. Alright, and our smarts went up a little bit, but nothing's happening. Let's get us up. Oh. Okay, great. So at the fresh age of 6 years old, we get chicken pox. Fun. Was I not vaccinated or what? Vaccinate your children. I mean, we need to go to the doctor. We're gonna go to Dr. Tina because we stan women becoming doctors. Okay, good for you, sis. Good for you. Okay, and Tina. Tina says she came through. She treated our chicken pox, and our mom has decided to vaccinate us from now on, so love that. We're still ugly, like, boy. Okay. Let's study hard in school. At age 6, we're just really grinding those books. We can always get our looks to go up with some plastic surgery, but in order to pay for that plastic surgery, we gonna need a degree, and we gonna need a good job, or we gonna need a sugar daddy, but I don't know how we're gonna get a sugar daddy if we ugly. So, our next best bet is going to school. Let's, you know, compliment our dad, by the way. Just have some relationship with our parents. Let's insult our mom because she didn't vaccinate us. We called her a sucker. Okay. I'm starting to suspect that I may have been adopted. Adopted? So you mean that this bitch who didn't vaccinate me ain't even my mom? She ain't even pushed me out her Gucci. Wow. It really be like that. It really be your own family. Let's have a conversation with her. Be like, are we fighting? Am I adopted? Mom, you need to tell me the truth. This is not funny. You and your mother had a heart-to-heart about who would win in a fight between Beyonce and Nicki Minaj. I would pay to see that fight, though I don't think they would fight, but like, okay, she didn't give us any answers on if we are adopted or not, so let's ask my dad. Conversation. You and your father talked about which politician should be elected. Okay, yes, start them early at the ripe age of 10 years old. Politics are important. I am very political, and you know what? I'm here for it. We love our dad. We are ugly as can fucking be, but we are 100% happy, so I guess that's okay. Oh, your mother wants to take you to watch toy unboxing videos. Will you go with her? What kind of toys, Mom? The ones you used when you weren't getting pregnant with me, and you were adopting me instead. And we'll keep studying in school. I studied for elementary school until I went cross-eyed. Okay, funny story. Actually, when I was really young, they discovered that I had, like, an extra muscle or something in my eye, like my left left eye, and it would like cause me to go cross-eyed a little bit, and I had to get eye surgery when I was 3 years old to fix it, and I've always just had bad eyesight ever since. But yeah, so literally me as a child, I was cross-eyed, but I was cute, okay? I was not 8% looks, okay? I was 100%, always have been, always will be. Don't try it. Okay, a boy from school, Dustin, has asked you out. How did this happen? How did this happen? He has good looks, good smarts. He's not that popular, but like, he's good looking and he's smart, so who cares? Yes. Okay, Dustin, we got a man. We got a man. We got a man, even though we're ugly. Yes. That is called finesse, sisters. Thank you. Oh. Never mind. And he wants to break up. Right after. Okay, love that. Love that for me. Ladies, here is a little lesson in relationships, romance, whatever. If someone wants to leave you, wish them well and move on. You can find better. We can find a boy that's more popular and has a bigger peen, okay? Even though we are literally 13. So probably shouldn't be thinking about that, but you know what I mean. Don't beg anyone to stay. I'm wondering a lot lately how nothing is on fire. Fire is on things. This bitch crazy. Do we have a little pyromaniac on our hands? I'm not ready for this. We are 14. We do not need to be thinking about fire. I started high school. Okay, so now this is when shit gets real. Okay, we're gonna find a man. We're gonna get good grades. We are gonna turn our life around, because right now we are only semi-smart and we are ugly. And we had our first boyfriend ever dump us literally right after, so we have nowhere to go but up. Time to take your driving test. Will you take it? Yes. What does this road sign mean? Three-way yield. Fuck. Okay, well, apparently we can't go anywhere but up. We gotta go down a little bit more before we can go up. Can we try again? Yep, okay. Well, we need money to take the driving test again, and we're broke as shit. So let's go to our lovely father and ask him for some money. He gave us enough money. Okay, love that. Thanks, Dad, so much. You're the best. While we're here, though, let's just low-key also ask our mom. And this is why our dad has always been the favorite parent. Are you kidding me? He gave me $66 in my hand, right in the back. Finesse. And then my mom turns around and gives me $2. Okay, you fake asshole. Thank you very much. I'll take your $2, though. Okay, so now let's go take the test again. What does this road sign mean? I'm gonna say farm machinery crossing. Yes! Last time to get ill, but tonight I bounce back. Okay, and we still have $23 left over. Cha-ching. Let's find someone to love. At the ripe age of 15. You're tempted to ask out a boy named Raymond. Okay. He's very attractive, pretty smart, semi-popular. I feel like he's gonna reject us. But let's try it. Yep, yep. He rejected us. That's fine. It's fine. It's fine. Okay. We're not hurt. Okay. Oh, we graduated from high school. Do we wanna go to school? We have to. It's the only way we can pay for a nose job and a butt job and get our looks up so we aren't super ugly, so that we can 4 year plastic surgery. Let's start with some Botox. We need more plastic surgery. We are not done eyelid surgery for 2000. Get it? Yes. Okay. Let's do more. We could probably do one more. Okay, let's get lipo. Oh. That really worked. Oh my god. Look, we're at 97% looks. And we're only 25. We really finessed. It's been a long journey, but we have bounced back and we are better than ever, and it's time to get a sugar daddy, okay? Let's go to a dating app. They need to have a lot of money, and they need to be old. The dating app has paired us with a guy named Clayton. Apparently he has a lot of money. His name is 60, so he's a little bit old. Maybe we could just, you know, have him have a heart attack or something. I don't know. Let's go on a date. We are dating. Okay, so we have our 60-year-old pediatrician sugar daddy. Perfect. Let's browse other jobs. See if there's something better. A porn cameraman. Apply. fault, so I don't know if we can have a baby, but then I think I will have lived my best life. I've experienced everything I need to experience, and I'll be good. So, let's spend time with our husband. And he died. Skip the funeral. We got $139,000. Thank you, ma'am. And you know what that means? Round three. Okay, so this guy's name is Salvador. He has quite a lot of money, and he's 70, so we'll go on a date with him. And then right away, just, you know, compliment him. Spend time with him. And propose to him. And he said yes, of course he did, because we are hot. We're not as hot as we were, but we're also 45, so, you know, whatever. And let's plan our wedding. Just at the courthouse, no honeymoon. $45, do it. He's demanding we sign a prenup. Well, we're not really trying to get divorced. We're just trying to inherit his money when he dies. So, I guess that's fine, right? Okay. Our happiness is kind of low, so we need to do something to make us happy. So, I think we need to go on a vacation because we are not the happiest. So, let's go on an Alaskan cruise with a interior suite. Sure, we'll just do a little bit cheaper. I've actually been on an Alaskan cruise and it was really nice, so your husband wants to go with you. Sure, come with, I don't care. $2,000, worth it. And our happiness boosted up. That's the truth. Going on cruises, like, really does make me so happy. You hear your husband called out another woman's name when having sex. He cheated, but we need his money, and he made us sign a prenup. No wonder we signed a prenup, because he's a cheating asshole. Whatever, we will forgive and forget until he's dead, and then we won't be attending his funeral, and we're gonna spend all his money on other dudes and getting some more dick. Okay, love that. That's the best revenge. We have hemorrhoids now. This is going so well. So well. We're gonna go back to Tina and be like, sis, please help me treat my hay fever. Treat my hemorrhoids. Okay, hemorrhoids are treated. Thank you very much. You're angry because another driver's tailing you and flashing her lights while you're out driving with your husband. What will you do? Let's just make an angry gesture, whatever. We got in a car accident. My hip is crushed and my Porsche contained damages. Repair it. Okay. Yes! 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 We stayed with this cheating asshole, but he finally died, and look at that inheritance. $766,000. Skip his funeral, motherfucker. We are a millionaire. We are a million. We're a millionaire. A millionaire. Okay, this has gone so good. So much better than I had originally thought it was gonna go. Now that we are finally a millionaire, I think it's time to find a true daddy, a true man that we want to settle down and try to have a kid with and buy a house, you know? So, we're gonna find someone to love. Okay, so we're gonna get married to our fiancé, but we're kind of rich, and he's not really rich, he's just really hot. So I think we're gonna make him sign a prenup. And he agreed. And then we got married. Perfect. So, since this is my last husband, I'm gonna all the way change my name. And let's try and have a baby. I'm kind of old, though, so I don't know if I can even get pregnant, but we're gonna try, but we failed, okay? Let's just keep trying. Tried, but failed. Tried, but failed. Come on. Come on. My mother passed away. She died of complications. No inheritance or anything from her, so we're gonna skip the funeral. I don't even think she was our real mom. Okay. Your husband called you awesome. Thank you so much, Brian. You're so sweet. I guess this means we need to go to a fertility and get in vitro. So, Miami Fertility for $8,000 or Miami Fertility for $13,000. We're going to get the more expensive one because I feel like that has a better chance of working. We're too old. Bitch, fuck you. And we can't do it. Okay, so we can just pay with cash. I hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you all in my next video.